Hi, I'm Nick Speed, and you've joined me at Clumber Park Lane. Today, I'm having a go for some big bream because the other day I had a really good day. I had 5 bream, just short of £49. And for that reason, I thought it'd be a good idea to bring along the cameras and see if I could actually catch one of these big bream for the cameras. So, as you can see, it's an absolutely beautiful lake. And as a basic approach, I'm using a method feeder to catch the bream, which is quite an unbeknown way of catching the bream, but in this kind of scenario you can understand why. I'm fishing amongst a hell of a lot of weed, which means that I need to ensure that my hook bait is directly above my bait. If I were to, in normal conditions, fish a feeder, I'd know for a fact that my hook bait is definitely not on top of my bait. So by fishing a method feeder, I know that whilst my bait's out there, it's nice and clean, and as a result I'm using a buoyant hook bait, which means it's actually off the bottom, above the bait, and free from any debris that it's going to catch on the bottom, and which makes obviously more visible for the fish to see when they come into my peg. A nice bright bait above my ground bait, they can see it straight away and pick it up. So basically the setup for this is an inline 35 gram Drennan inline feeder with a 3-inch hook length to 0.20 diameter hook length to a size 14 eyed hook, and I've used a bayonet which I'm going to put into my corn, which is obviously, because it's artificial corn, you know, this sticks straight in and you can catch several fish on just one grain of corn. It doesn't even come off. So in here I've got a single grain of corn that I've soaked in some Legend bream attractor, some dynamite baits, Ron Hutchinson's bream attractor. Absolutely brilliant, because it just, with the natural, with the buoyancy of this bait, it actually absorbs the flavour as well, so it seems to hold on to its flavour for a while. All I'm doing now is I'm just going to get my bayonet and I'm going to stick it into the piece of corn there like that, and then with the back of my nail I'm just going to push it right in so it sits like that, and very, very difficult for it to come out. For my feed, I've got ground bait and micro pellets. The reason for that is that I want to ensure that every time I cast out, I'm leaving some bait behind. Ground bait alone isn't enough in this depth of water. I want particle baits for the fish to stay in my peg. So that's why I've mixed 50-50 ground bait with 50-50 2mm pellets. And I've used my mix of dynamite, green swim stim, and marine halibut in equal quantities. This is the perfect mix I've found for the average method feeder. It's a nice sticky mix, and it works on the majority of the venues where you want to use the method feeder. So as a basic approach, all I'm doing is filling my method feeder up, just causing a little indentation there in my finger, a bit more on top, and then I use the mould obviously just to shape it off, which means that when I'm casting 100 yards I know for a fact that it's going to fly exactly the same way, which means that hopefully I'm going to reach my target every time. Now the principle behind this is, obviously I've explained, it sat there in the water, that's going to break down, and eventually that yellow piece of corn is going to come out and it's directly going to be buoyant above my hook, above my feed. So the fish can see that there's feed around, and because of the contrast in the bait, they're going to pick my bait out straight away. So what we're going to do is just bait up again and I'll have a cast for a bream. So just cause a little pinch there, a bit more on top, just the feeder in the mould. Press it really hard to ensure that when the feeder hits the surface, the majority of that bait doesn't come off. What I'm trying to achieve is ensuring that that is like that when it hits the bottom. Oh mate, that's a big one. I think we've got it. That's a big one. Well, I've had an absolute cracking day. I've had 6 bream, 4 of them over 9 pounds, 1 ounces, and to top it off, on the last cast of the day, I've had this absolute cracker at 10 pounds, 13 ounces. If you want to read more, check out Angling Times for the full story. So we're now going to put him back.